Let us continue with the contour gradient. What is contour gradient? This point we have discussed while discussing the uses of contouring. In that, we have discussed that if we have to construct or plan a road through hilly region or mountainous region, then we cannot construct a road of any gradient like that. Suppose this is the mountain we have discussed and we have to construct a road. Then we don't construct a road like this because it is not possible to follow that gradient. Okay, so here what we do, we choose a certain gradient while designing that road in the hilly area based on topography. We choose certain gradient in between 1 in 20 or 1 in 30. What is this 1 in 20, 1 in 30? Gradient is nothing but it is a simply slope. We are discussing a gradient 1 in 20. So what is 1 in 20? 1 in 20 means 1 vertical to 20 horizontal. Means when we go 20 meter horizontal, while going 20 meter horizontal, we climb 1 meter vertical. This is the slope 1 in 20. What is 1 in 30? While moving this 30 meter horizontal, we will climb 1 meter vertical. This is 1 in 30. 1 in 30. This is 1 in 20. Okay. So, means here what we select? We select some slope and it based on many factors such as hauling power of vehicles. So, here what we do first? While we first select the points, we'll mark first the points of this required gradient. Let it be 1 in 20, 1 in 30. We'll mark some points of required gradient along this path of the mountain. And then we join these points. These points of gradient we have marked. And this line joining these points we marked of certain gradient, that grade, the line joining this grade point is called as contour gradient. What is contour gradient? While moving through the hilly area, while surveying for a road in hilly area, we assume certain gradient and we plot some points with that gradient. Okay. And the line joining that point is known as contour gradient. Now we'll discuss the methods plotting this contour gradient. So one method is we can plot this ground on a map, and another method that we can plot it by using leveling instrument. Okay, there are two methods. Here we are going to discuss these two methods. That so let us start with the map. Suppose this is a map of one hilly area with a contour interval of 2 meter. So this is a line of contour 96 meter. This is the line of contour 98 meter. This is a line with a contour 100 meter. And now here we have to plot a contour gradient or we have to select the point for a contour gradient of with a grade 1 in 30 meter. Okay, what gradient we need here? 1 in 30 meter. What it means? It means while moving 30 meter horizontal, we have to move 1 meter vertical. Okay, so suppose this is the map. Okay, this is the with the contour interval of 2 meter. Now, what is the gradient we have selected? 1 in 30 meter. And this contour interval is of 2 meter. So, this 2 meter will cover between these two lines. How much horizontal distance we have to cross? To maintain the slope of 1 in 30. That is, slope is 1 in 30. Okay, if we have to maintain this slope, how much we should go horizontal for 2 meter? For 2 meter, it is 60 meter. So, for this, contour interval of 2 meter, we need how much distance between these two contour interval, horizontal distance between these two contour lies? 60 meter distance. Then what will be the our gradient? That is, this is contour interval is 2 meter, that is 96-98, difference between 98 and 96 is 2 meter, plus 2 meter in how much distance? In 60 meter horizontal. So here we can follow the gradient, 1 in 30 meter. So for that, what we do first, we'll select the starting point, we'll find out, we select first starting point on this map. Then after selecting starting point, we'll convert this 60 meter distance to the scale of this map, and we will mark one arc on this next contour line. Now this is the point on contour of RL 98 meter. So we can join this point like this. Now what is this gradient? This is a gradient of 1 in 30 meter. Got it? Means there is a contour interval of 2 meter. So to maintain that 1 in 30 gradient, how much horizontal distance we should cover? That is 60 meter. So 60 meter distance we will convert to the scale according to scale of the map, and we will select first point on this contour, and then we mark an arc with the distance of this 60 meter. Okay, so here we have covered 2 meter vertical with the 60 meter horizontal distance. Similarly, for the next point, suppose this is point P, this is point Q. So again for point R, again we are considering 60 meter distance, and we will converting it to the scale according to scale of the map, and we will mark another arc like that. And here it is again point R with a gradient 1 in 30 meter. Got it? So here, how do we plot the contour gradient on the map? According to interval, contour interval of the map, and according to the gradient we have to follow. Okay, we'll select that distance and we'll convert that with the scale, and we'll mark the arc on the map, and line joining these points is called as contour gradient. This is the process of plotting contour gradient on a map. Now next method is by leveling instrument. For to plot contour gradient with the leveling instrument, first we'll select any point on a ground, and we'll calculate RL of this point. So point on the ground. Then suppose RL of this point on the ground is suppose 100 meter. Okay. Then we will again this RL we have find it out from the benchmark. There will be some benchmark, and from that we'll find out the RL for the starting. Then we'll set some instrument at some point, leveling instrument at some point, and we'll calculate the height of instrument. Okay, suppose that height of instrument is suppose 101.2 meter. Then we have set level at some point, and we have taken the backside reading at this point, and suppose we got the height of instrument as a 101.2. Means here we set a leveling instrument, and we have taken the reading at this point A, and its reading is 1.2, and its RL is 100, so our height of instrument has now become 101.2 meter. Okay, now suppose we have to plot here the contour gradient with the gradient 1 in 30 meter. In suppose falling gradient, we need here falling gradient of 1 in 30 meter. So what we'll do, we'll select a distance of 30 meter. We'll select a distance of 30 meter from point A, and we'll search for a staff reading. How do we can search for a staff reading? That we are discussing direct method of contouring, that required RL we can find it out by knowing the staff reading. So to get now for falling rate I'm wanting 30 meter and we have chosen the distance of 30 meter. So what should be the reading here on the stop should be for a 1 meter difference, that is point A at 100 meter. So next point we want of RL B, that should be of RL B should be of RL 99 meter to get a slope one in 30. Okay, so what is the stop reading for that? Request stop reading for that. What is the stop reading we need? 101.2 minus 99, that is 2.2 meter. So for which stop reading we search here? Along a distance of 30 meter from A, 2.2 meter. So we'll keep on going stop at different points at a distance of 30 meter from our leveling instrument to search for a stop reading of 2.2 meter. Suppose here we got 2.0 meter, here suppose we got 2.2 meter. So this is our point B. Okay, because here is its stop reading is 2.2. Okay, then 101 minus 2.2, here the RL we got the 99, and then this is the gradient, falling gradient of 1 in 20. This is point B, this is point A, here RL is 100 and here RL is 99. Here in this method, while searching for a reading, if reading is below or more up to 0.01 meter, that is allowed. Okay, but to find the next stop reading, we'll use the height of instrument at the previous station. Whenever we get such a point, we got a point B, we got point C. Whenever we get such a point, we'll fix the position of that point with the peg on the ground. So this is the method of plotting contour gradient with the help of leveling instrument. Here the peg interval is 30 meter. Suppose now peg interval is 50 meter. So we can calculate the RL of next point like that. How do we calculate the RL of next point? Here the peg interval was 30 meter. Suppose we need to plot the gradient with the peg interval of 50 meter. Then here, suppose if we consider the same situation, here the RL of first point is 100. Then if peg interval is 50 meter, then what should be the RL of the next point? It should be the what is the distance? Suppose this peg interval is 50 meter. Then 50 into gradient is 1 in 30. So it is 100 minus 50 by 30. It will come as a 98.33 meter. So here we will search for RL 98.33 meter.